So yes, so we were supposed to create tables in all these sheets. So I'll just say Control T. Just place your doc. Control T. Okay, this is already a table. So we have to perform here. Control T, and my table has headers. So you can go here, change the format. See, if you want to apply some borders and colors, then fine, you can keep it. So if you wish to see your data as is, you just give none. So no formatting will be applied on it. Let's say Control T. So same thing with all these, you just have to perform it like this. My table has headers. So you have to rename them as well. So now suppose you have something like this, you have to rename these tables. Now let me give all the tables a uniform format. I've just changed the format of all the tables to the same thing. Now, when you place your cursor on the table, you can see here a table tools tab has been opened. You can see design over here. So you see the name of the table. So you just have to change the name over here. I'll type it as TBL expense. And press enter. So you have to do the same with department as well. TBL department. You need to rename all these tables in this way so that you will be able to identify which table it is. And make sure when you create the table, you don't forget to give this my table has headers. So otherwise, your headers will not be visible when you give this pivot table creation. So you have to again modify. So to avoid such things, just make sure you give the option that is my table has headers. So now we have renamed all the tables. After you have done with this, so you can just go and insert pivot table on any table you want. Any table that you have here, you just go here, just say Alt-NV. So that's the shortcut we used. You can see here it is taking the table name that we gave. Now I want to create this pivot table in a new worksheet. After this is selected, you need to choose this. Choose whether you want to analyze multiple tables. In that section, you just give add this data to the data model. Only when you enable this, all the other tables in the same workbook is considered. So if you don't select this, pivot table is inserted only on the single table that you have chosen currently. Just say okay. It takes some time. You can see in the status bar, it says loading data model. So once it loads, it takes a few minutes. Once it loads, you will be able to see a blank layout of pivot table over here. See, it displays this. And you can see the active table on which your pivot table is inserted. When you just go change the tab to all, you will be able to see all those tables which you have included in this workbook. All the tables will be visible here. Now suppose you want to create a report using all these tables, data that we have in all these tables. Now I want to see the expense based on a particular account, let's say, let's choose account name. See, I want the account name. We have seen account numbers in expense data, but we would like to see the report based on the name of the account. So just choose the account name. It will be visible now. Now go to expense table. And you need to choose amount here. But you can see the same amount is being displayed. That's because it's giving the total expense in the expense table. It is the total expense. See, we would like to see the subtotals based on the account names that we have chosen. So for that, you need to create relationships between these tables first. How to do that? Either you can go here and click on auto detect. So it will detect sometimes, sometimes it doesn't. So now you can see it has not done the job. So you can just close it. You could create these relationships manually between the tables. So go to analyze tab. You have something known as relations in this calculations group. Just take relationships and click on new. So here you need to choose a table which has got all the other columns unique numbers. That table is expense. I'll just choose that. So which is the next table? See, you have selected table expense. This table has got unique numbers of all the other tables, which is present here. Now I want to connect it with table account. I'll choose this. Now which column is common to these two? I have account number in expense table. So we have the same column in table account as well. So based on this, I am going to create a relationship. There should be something matching between those two tables in order to create a relationship. So here we have account number, which is common to both the tables. I choose that. So likewise, you can create relationship with all the other tables that we have so that it is easy for us to create reports quickly. So I choose branch here. See unit name, see the unit number in business unit number in expense table is same as unit in the branch table. Just say okay. It will check for that and it will create the relation. You can see here which are the column numbers that are considered to create this relationship. You can see that here. So I'll just do the same with the other tables as well. So now let me take currency. So we have currency here, same currency name over currency table as well. Just click OK. Again, take table. This table expense is common to all the other tables that you have. So when you're creating this relationship, we have to choose that always, because that is the table which has connection to all the other tables. Now here we have department numbers. So I'll just say okay. Now all the tables are connected to each other. We have created the relationship. Just close it. Once we are done with it, now you can see the amount has changed automatically. You can see there's a change in amount. You could also create reports based on the branch name. See, now I'll just put this branch name in columns. You'll be able to see it this way. So using the data across all the sheets that we have, you can prepare the pivot tables. This is known as data modeling using pivot tables. And you could also create dashboard like we did yesterday on this, but make sure there is some data that is common between both the tables in order to create this relationship. Okay, is that all clear to you guys?
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
So now how did we get this report? I'll just summarize it really quick. So we had data present in different sheets. To connect them together, we first created tables out of the same data. So it was a cell range. We created tables. Later, we renamed those tables After renaming the tables, we inserted a pivot table on one of the tables. So here I chose expense table. You could choose any of it. Any table is fine. You just have to create a pivot, insert a pivot table using any table we have here. Once the table is created, so once the pivot table is inserted, you have to check for this active and all. Okay. When you click on all, you will be able to see all the tables that we have created. After this, we have to create relationships between each of them based on the columns that are common among these tables. After the relationship is created, you will be able to create reports using the pivot tables. Is it clear now? Is it clear?
Yes, madam. Yes, madam.
Now let's take another topic. So the last one that we have here, printing techniques. So I'll be teaching you that. I'll just share the window with you. Yes. So printing techniques. So let me show you here. Whenever you have a very large data to be printed, that's when the problem arises. Otherwise, most of the time people will manage to print it properly. Only when you have multiple sheets over here and you have to provide headers, footers, all these things, you are going to be careful with the arrangements that you're going to do here. So let me show you. So now if I give print, so for print command, you just have to say Control P. It will take you to this print window and it will show you the number of sheets being printed, in which layout it is. So what is the orientation? See, currently it is in portrait orientation. So the length of the sheet is more and the data is printed on the length of the sheet, not on the breadth. So when I change the page orientation, you see, I choose landscape, it will print in this manner. Now, when we have to compare many columns, when I want to accommodate many columns in the sheet, I would like to keep it as landscape. So you can change it right here. That's fine. And again, you can also choose to print only a range of sheets. So you always don't have to print all the sheets that you have in the document. You can just go here, mention, I want to print from 1 to, let's say, 5. So it will print only 5 sheets in that case. So if you don't have any particular range, then all of this will be printed. And again, you have another option here, collated. See, uncollated and collated. So this will be really helpful if you are preparing some question sheets. So sheets where you have printed some questions or something like that. See, when I say collated, if I have 3 sheets to be printed, let's say page 1, 2, 3. Every set, and I want to print 10 copies of it. So it will print like this, page 1, page 2, page 3, page 1, page 2, page 3, 10 times in a set. Now if I say uncollated, it will print first page 10 copies, second page 10 copies, and third page 10 copies. So in this way, it is going to be printed. Based on your requirement, you're going to choose whether it has to be collated or uncollated. And you also have options to choose here to change the size of the sheet. See, many times you have to print on a letter size or legal document or statement. So different size of sheets are chosen here. And you can also always go take more paper sizes and choose here. So how exactly it has to be. So sometimes we would like to print on a check or envelopes. So you will choose based on the page size that you want to, okay, and also the print quality. All these things can be managed over here. Now let's say margins. See, again, this is also an important aspect. So what margins you want to provide? So you have some predefined ones. Either you can choose this or you can always go customize the margins as well. I'll show you this. Okay. And scaling. See, we have not scaled it. See, sometimes let's say I'll go here, fit sheet on one page. You see this? I am trying to print all the data in a single this thing. So this doesn't look good. You will not be able to understand anything here. Now when I say no scaling, no shrinkage of data is there. So the data is visible with the font that I have provided in the document. The same size is printed here. I have not shrunk the data. Okay. So the scaling is to 100%. Actual size of your data is taken here. So if you say fit all columns on one page or all rows on one page, so your data will shrink and in most of the cases, it will not be visible. Okay. So if you have very few columns and rows, fine. You can do that adjustment. So if you have only two columns going to the next sheet or only two or three rows going to the next sheet, you can always go here and choose this. Now this is about on the surface, you know, making changes. So there are more to it. Now I was telling how to provide header and footer. Now suppose, so I'll again show you when we print it. See, in the first sheet, I have these two columns, zone and drug, and I also have the header. Now suppose I'll check the second sheet, the header is gone, but still I have these first two columns. So you can scroll down to other sheets. So I'll give somewhere near 56. You see, we don't have the first two columns, no header, only these numbers are going to be printed. In this case, I'll not be able to understand the data at all because I don't know which month's data it is and which drugs or regions data it is. So to understand the data when it is printed, it is essential that I have this heading in every sheet and the first two columns also. So how to get it done? So you have in page layout tab, something known as print titles. Just click on it. You have all the page setup options over here in the same place. See, in this sheet, you have to take rows to repeat at top. Let's go here. Choose the row that has to repeat in every sheet. Columns, if you have any columns to be repeated, you can choose that also. We want the first two columns to repeat. I'll just take that and say okay. Now, again, let's check the print preview. You look at it. You have the first two columns and the header in every sheet. You just have to go here. I just give 90. That's the last sheet. Even in the last sheet, you can see all the headers and the first two columns are visible to us. So now I'll be able to understand this data without any problem. But that's not all. How exactly it is printing the data? We need to check that also. Let's go to page break preview. So I was telling you, this will show me the order of the pages, in which order my pages are getting printed. So you can see here in the first page, it is printing from zone to July 2011. So let me zoom it. See, this says till July, it's going to print. But if I have to start looking at the August data, it is not appearing in the second sheet. You look at it. The page number is 31. See, we would like to first see the data for the zone mentioned here to the entire period that we have taken. Next, it has to move to the other zone data. Correct? So the order should be in that manner. Currently, so it is printing down, then over. I'll just change that. you just have to change the page order. Again, go back to print titles. See, you have this page order here. Just say over, then down, and just say okay. Now you can see it has taken page 2 over here. Okay, so this is how we change the order of the page. Now suppose I will start printing it. Due to some interruption, my printing stopped. Now I don't know from where exactly I have to continue. To manually check till where it has printed, what has happened, it's going to take a long time, and I would get annoyed to figure it out like that. So instead, if I had page numbers printed on it, it would be really easy for me to identify from which page I have to start printing from. Otherwise, so many pages would have been wasted if I start printing it from the beginning. So to save on these things, you should go again, choose print titles. You have header and footer option here. See, you go here. Usually page numbers are given in the footer section. So I'll just choose this. Apart from the text, see, you should not type the page numbers like this, 1, 2. So if you provide the page numbers, the same number is printed in all the sheets. So we would like to see different numbers in different sheets. So if at all you have some text to be printed, you can give this. And it is divided in 3 sections, left, center, and right. So in which section you want to print, you have to first choose that. Now I would like to print page numbers in the right hand side. Let's. So you have the option here. Page number, insert page number. You need to choose this. And I would also like to see the total number of pages within the file that I'm trying to print. Just say off. You could give a slash, hyphen, or type off. Anything is fine. I'll just say again, insert number of pages. This will give me the total number of pages within my file. You also have a lot of other things if you want to include print date, printing time, your file path, so the file name and sheet name. And if you have any small image also to be included, like a logo or something like that, even that also can be included using this. Now I'll say okay. Let's check in the print preview. You look at the page numbers here in the corner. I'll just scroll it. You will be able to see the change in the page number over here. So likewise, you can also provide on the other information. You could use header, or even in header, you have the same options. So you can choose from there. And suppose you have some images or charts or some shapes, let's say, and you don't want to print them. So usually when you insert any image, let me show you. Let me go back to normal. I'm unable to. Okay, I need to unprotect it. Now let me show you in another file. I'll insert some shape here. Along with this, I have some text to be printed. Now if I print it, I'll say Control P. You just see, along with the shape or image or chart, anything. See, it will appear right along with the text. Suppose I don't want this image or shape or chart to be printed. You have an option. You just have to select that, right click, say format shape. You go to this size and properties. See, in properties, just remove the selection on print object. It will not be printed. If you remove that selection, it will not be printed. Now let's go back to print preview. See, you only see the text part now. You don't get to see any shape or image or chart. So for everything, so any other object that you provide here, you, if you wish to print it, you can keep it. If you don't wish to print it, you can always go and uncheck that option. Okay. I'll just close this. Were you people able to see that? So the image thing? Please answer me. Could you see this?
No.
Then you kept mum. How will I know if you didn't see? Okay, let me show you again. See, I'm trying to insert a shape here. Now let's say, see, in place of this shape, you could also insert an image or a chart or any picture, anything in this place. Okay, it all works in the same manner. Now I have some text along with it, let's say. Now if I try printing it, you can see even the shape or image or chart, whatever I've given, that also appears here. Now I don't want this to get printed. I only want the text to be printed. So what you could do, just right click on the shape, just go to size and properties. In properties, you have this print object option. Remove this. And now again check how to print it, giving Control P. You can see here. Okay. So the image or shape or chart which you don't want, you can just go and change the properties so that it will not be printed. So you can perform these things using this printing options. These are the various printing techniques that I wanted to share with you. Let me okay. Yes, if you have